What's up, MMA fans? Today we are catching up with Carlos Nightmare Prates. Welcome, Carlos.
Thank you. Thanks so much. It's an honor for me being here, talking to you. Before I was saying, you talk with a lot of legends of MMA, and now it's a pleasure talking with you, bro.
Yeah, man. You did a great job against, you got a 3 wins straight. And you got an impressive knockout over Li Jingliang. It's the third bonus you got. Tell us, what are your game plan coming for that fight?
It's not all about me, but it's about my team, my coaches also, because my heavy plan is always the same. It's always to step on the cage, start to hurt my opponents, and kick the leg, hurt the body, and then when they start to think about like, I cannot hold that for 3 rounds, and they start to rush the fight to try to finish, and then they start to give me space to knock them out. So my coach I just do what my coach say to me, and they start to study my opponents and things like that, and I just go there and I just did what they said.
And talking about the way you don't rush to knock out the opponents. Once I saw an interview you did, and you said it's everything to do with all the time you spend in Thailand studying Muay Thai. You live there almost 6 years. And the Muay Thai experience make you behave like that?
Yeah, Muay Thai is it. It is really important in my game because I have more than 100 Muay Thai fights. And Muay Thai, to win the fight, you need to hurt your opponent, you know? And like you, when I fight MMA, I try to do the same because I'm not the strongest guy on the division. I don't want to knock you out with just one punch. So I prefer like you go slowly, go hurt my opponent, going like kicking him and like make he, how can I explain, make he give up, you know, like he yeah. Yeah, I start to win the fight when he punch me or when he start to hit me, not because he want to knock me out. He don't want to hurt me. He just hit me to me to stay away of him, you know? And then I my coach started to say, not rush, just hurt him. And with Jingliang already, I knew already, after the first knockdown, I saw like, yeah, he's done already. So I just need to keep it going slow and then knock him out.
And that is something all you guys from Fighting Nerds does, or is it something specific from you? And it's amazing how Fighting Nerds got in the UFC. I talked to your coach Pablo Sucupira. You guys got in the UFC 2 years ago, and 3 weeks ago he talked to me. You guys already had like 21 wins and only 2 defeats. So you have Mauricio Huff in 70 kilos category, Jean Silva in 66, you in 77, and Caio Borralho in 84. So tell us a little more about Fighting Nerds.
Yeah, the name is say everything is Fighting Nerds, you know. Pablo is like a nerd of the fight world. To me, on my fight camp, he's like the brain of the team because he do a lot of videos, explain about my opponent during the fight, when they fight us, when he fights a southpaw opponent, when it's the beginning of the fight, what he like to do and things like that. So I think the name is the right name, you know, to Fight Nerds, because they really like to study the opponent and like they give me everything done. I just need to step on the cage and have fun.
And what do you expect from Caio Borralho next Saturday in the fight against Cannoneer?
You know, Kyle is on his prime. Six wins in a row in UFC. And to be honest, I don't think it's going to be a hard fight to Kyle. He needs to be like he... on the beginning of the fight, of course, Cannonier is really strong. One hand can finish the fight, but Kyle has a really good boxing. He moves all the time, his head. It's really hard to find him. Also, his grappling is really good. Really, he have a really good level of wrestling, BJJ. So I think Kyle gonna start to put some pressure. And then I think Cannonier cannot hold that for 5 rounds. Probably he's gonna get tired, he's gonna get hurt, and then Kyle gonna win the fight.
And also, let me ask you, Carlos, you asked Chaos Williams, but maybe UFC, let's say that UFC, after 3 bonus, they believe you deserve a ranked opponent. I'm going to say some names, and you tell me which one you think you can make another great fight. Kevin Holland, 15. 14, Michael Page. 13, Vicente Luque. New Magny, 12. 11, Joaquin Buckley. Geoff Neal, number 10. And Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, number 9. Let's keep between 15 and 9. Which guys you like the best here in that names? Which one you think you can give a better fight?
I think I would have a really good fight against all of them, but to be honest, my last fight in Australia, I saw something like Kevin Holland was without opponent. Yeah, his first opponent, you know, how's the name?
Chris Curtis.
Yeah, Chris Curtis was out of the fight. He was planning to get the mic after the fight and then ask to fight him. But one day before, they say Dolidze come to his place and gonna fight Kevin Holland. I also would like to fight Joaquin Buckley. I think he would be a great fight to the people, to MMA fans. Also good fight for me. But he have a fight already, he have opponent already. I think Stephen Thompson. I think he's gonna fight Steve Thompson.
Yeah, I think so. Yeah.
Yeah, and I don't know. I don't like to fight Vicente Luque because he's Brazilian. But if you have to fight, of course you're gonna fight. But it's not my first choice. And I think Michael Page would be a really good fight.
Nice. Yeah, number 14 as a king of striking too would be an amazing matchup, huh?
yeah, I would like to fight him. Would be a great bonus again.
Oh yeah, you believe you can knock him out?
Yeah, you could knock him out. You know, the first time he lost to Douglas Lima.
Uh huh.
I was the sparring partner of Douglas.
Oh really?
I was doing like MVP, and Douglas was doing his game. He Douglas and Jucão. His coach come to Thailand and he trained all together. He trained with Leo, my coach in Thailand, and we trained all together. So it's like it's kind of, I know the way to knock the guy out.
Oh, great. Yeah, maybe the UFC make that happen. Let's see.
Yeah.
And also, let me ask you, with all Muay Thai experience you have, how do you see Poatan and Khalil round 3?
Bro, to be honest, I trained before with Khalil Huntry. He's a nice guy. He's a good fighter. But I don't think he can fight more than one round with Poatan. You know, Poatan is a different level of striking. And also, he said in an interview of Khalil, he's saying he have no plans to try takedown. So I think the first round, Poatan gonna knock him out, and that's it. In light heavyweight, I think maybe Ankalaev can fight good against him, but that's it. And other guys, I don't think they winning the fight against Poatan. Now Poatan He's the guy of the moment. He's the guy of UFC right now. Really good striker. Probably training a lot of takedown defense, getting better day by day. So I don't know. Yeah, for Khalil Huntry, I think 1 round, 2 rounds, and pop, I'm gonna knock him out.
And talking about the next title fight of your division, Belal Muhammad against Rakhmonov, who do you think is gonna win that one?
It's hard to say because every time when I don't really watch the fights, you know, I don't like to watch fights. I prefer soccer, F1, but every time when I saw something about Belal Muhammad, everybody say like, he's gonna lose. And every fight he won, and against Leon Edwards, I was thinking also he would lose, but was impressive like the way he get the win. So now I, to be honest, I don't know. I think Shavkat is longer, he's higher, but I don't know. I think he's 50-50. Yeah. But I think Shavkat gonna win because he have a better strike.
Better strike. And yeah. I have to ask you about cigarettes. Everybody ask you that, and tell the fans how does it affect you? How you started smoking? Was in Thailand, and how it affects your training? If you're trying to stop, or it doesn't bother you at all?
To be honest, when I started to smoke, I was like 12, 13 years old, because my mom was working a lot. My family is only me and my mom, and the point of my life when I was 12 and 13, my mom had to pay everything here in my home and things, your bills and things like that, and also take care about my grandparents. So she was working at morning, afternoon, at night, and I was on the street all day. So you know, when you live on the street, like with your friends, you learn a lot of bad things, a lot of bad habits, and start to smoke was one of them. So I don't know if how can say the right word, if it can disturb me like you on the training or the fights, because I think I have more time alive smoking than without smoking. But no, I don't think so. Right now, maybe when I was close to 40 years old, something like that, a little bit older, maybe, but now, I don't know.
Great. And talking about your mom, you told me that's why you have such a nice English. She's an English teacher.
Yeah, she in Brazil, she was teaching already English, Portuguese, and also, I don't know the name, I don't know the right translation in English. No, it's like something about the books in Brazil, you know?
Literature.
Yeah. And she worked a lot and also tried to teach me English, but I don't know if you have your mom, she's a teacher, it's really hard to study your mom, you know?
But when you went to Thailand, you have to learn by yourself.
Yeah. When I leave Brazil, I knew English already, but I didn't know how to talk English, because it's two things really different, you know. It's different you know English, and if you speak English, like you heard people saying something and then you need to reply, you need to answer. It's a little bit different, but it's like 1 year in Thailand, my first year, and then I was speaking English also already.
Great, Carlos, was a pleasure to interview you, and good luck in your next fight.
Thank you so much, bro. It's a pleasure for me talking with you today. Thanks so much for inviting me.